This video covers the rock, paper, scissors game using C and C++. Topics covered include the project definition, truth tables, keyboard character input using C and C++, converting to uppercase, literals versus variables, and using a loop to play the game over and over again. The project definition states, write a program to score the rock, paper, scissors game. Each of the two users types in either R, P, or S. The program then announces the winner as well as the basis for determining the winner. Paper covers rock. Rock breaks scissors. Scissors cut paper or tie game. Be sure to allow the user to use lowercase as well as uppercase letters. Your program should include a loop that lets the user play again until the user says she or he is done. There are 9 conditions to test for. If player 1 selects R for rock, player 2 could have rock, paper, or scissors. If player 1 selects paper, also player 2 could have rock, paper, or scissors. If player 1 selects scissors, player 2 could also select rock, paper, or scissors. We can use a truth table to help simplify the design and make sure that all conditions are tested. On one side, we'll put the combinations for the input for player 1, and across the top, put the input combinations for player 2. I can see that if the selection for player 1 is equal to the selection for player 2, it is a tie. So test for that first, and then test for the 6 other conditions that remain. Let's discuss the different ways to input a character from the keyboard. The method for inputting a single character from the keyboard is different between C and C++. The C language uses scanf and printf to input and output data to the terminal. A newer, more secure version of scanf is called scanf_s. The C++ language uses CIN and COUT to input and output data to the terminal. Let's take a peek at how the C language does the character input. We need to include standard IO.h. I'll define the character data type for player 1 and use printf to output the message player 1, input R, P, or S. I'll use scanf_s to input the character from the keyboard. Well, it says scanf_s, open parentheses, quote, percent C, quote. The percent C identifies that I'm going to be inputting into a character data type, ampersand player 1. The ampersand means address of. So I'm passing the address of the variable player 1 to scanf so that scanf will know where to put the result. Then I can say player 1 equals to upper player 1. In order to do the to upper function, I need to include ctype.h. To upper player 1 takes whatever's input and converts it into uppercase. The to upper function actually in itself does not change the value of player 1. It takes player 1, converts to uppercase, and returns the uppercase value. For example, if somebody typed in a capital R, well, it returns a capital R. But if somebody typed in a lowercase r, it returns a capital R. It's the assignment, the equal sign right there, that is going to take the result of to upper and then place it back into player 1. Then you need to do the same thing for player 2. The process is similar for using C++. This time I need to include IOStream, and I'll include the C++ version of ctype.h, which is called cctype. I also need to make sure I use using namespace standard. Define a character variable for player 1. Then you can say cout player 1, enter R, P, or S. Use CN to input from the keyboard and store it into player 1. Then, same thing, convert player 1 into uppercase. You need to do the same thing for player 2 if you're using the C++ language. The reason we want to convert to uppercase is it makes our if statement much easier. I can say if player 1 equal quote capital R quote, or I could say if player 1 equal quote capital S quote, or I could say if player 1 equal quote capital S quote. Instead, if I didn't convert to uppercase, I would have to say if player 1 equal quote capital R, or player 1 equal quote small r quote, and I'd have to test for the capital and the lowercase for each different combination. So converting to uppercase within our program just makes it easier to do the testing. Checking for a tie is really easy. All we need to do is to see if player 1 equal player 2. If that's the case, it's a tie game. I don't need to do three different tests to see if player 1 is a capital R and player 2 is a capital R. I don't have to test to see if player 1 is a capital P and player 2 is a capital P. And I don't need to do a test to see if player 1 equals capital S and player 2 equals a capital S. All I need to do is to see if they are equal. Then I know it's a tie. Cool? Let's discuss literals and variables. A numeric literal would be something like 5 or minus 12 or 37.962. A character literal might be the character R or the character L or anything like that. A character literal in C or C++ is defined by using a single quote around the literal. If you have a literal string, then it's defined by using the double quotes. You have to be careful, because if you said just something like R, well, without the quotes, that right there is the name of a variable, and you have to create the variable, and you have to initialize it before you use it. So you really can't compare against an R or a P or an S, unless you have declared those as variables and put something in them. But if we use a single quote around the R, then it's a literal, and then we can compare a variable against that literal. Your program still needs to do some input validation. So make sure that you check to see if the inputs are either an R, a P, or an S. If it's something else, like somebody types in an X, then put out a message to say illegal input. The easiest way to set up a loop is to create it before you put in the logic for the game itself. If you're using the C language, you have to modify this code to use printf and scanf underscore s. Here's an example. I'll define a character variable that says play again, and I'll initialize it to a small y. Then I can say do open curly brace, and all the code for the game goes in between the curly braces. At the bottom of my block of code, I'll say cout, do you want to play again? Then cin, play again. Close curly brace, and I'll end the loop by saying while play again equal quote big Y, single quote, or those are the two vertical bars, play again equal single quote little y single quote, close parentheses and a semicolon. If you want to change things a little bit, then maybe you can convert that play again to uppercase, and then you only need to test for a capital Y. That's the end of the hints for the rock, paper, scissor game. So the game itself is going to have a whole lot of if, else if statements in there to test for the different combinations for winning the game. Have fun with this one.